Hi students, so we are discussing about the world of microorganism. In last class we discussed about group of microorganisms, and we also discussed where this microorganism is present. We discussed about bacteria, we discussed about fungi, and we discussed about algae, we discussed about protozoa, we discussed about arthropods. Where the bacteria is present? Bacteria is present in the air, bacteria is present in the water, bacteria is present in the soil, bacteria is present in the intestine, bacteria is present in everywhere. Where fungus, we can see fungi, Rhizophus fungus. This fungus we can see in the other food materials, rotting food materials. If we keep any rotis or chapatis in the corner of the room, 2 days or 3 days or 4 days, we can see the black color structure is growing on the rotting food, on the rotis. This black color structure is nothing but the fungus, Rhizophus. Where we can see the algae? Algae we can see in pond water, the greenish color substances. Protozoa in the soil and water. Arthropods and the soil. We also discussed friend of the farmer, that is earthworms. Today we are going to see the observation of soil microorganism. Observing soil microorganism. Observing soil microorganism. Is a microorganism present in the soil or not? Yes. If in the field of the soil, 8 inches of soil, in the 8 inches of soil, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like 8 inches of the soil in the field, round there are 5.5 tons of bacteria is present. 5.5 tons of bacteria is present in wide 8 inches of the soil. Top 8 inches of the soil, around 5.5 tons. 1 ton is called, 1 quintal is nothing but 100 kg. 1 ton, 1,000 kg. 5,500 kg of bacteria is present only on 8 inches of soil. If we take 1 spoon of soil, in the 1 spoon of soil also we can see the thousands or lakhs of bacteria in 1 spoon of soil. This bacteria and fungi is present in the soil. They are very very useful for the plants growing. This bacteria, fungi are very very useful for the plants growing. So rhizobium bacteria is there in the soil. So this plants cannot take nitrogen directly. This rhizobium bacteria convert the nitrogen into nitrate. They can absorb it. This nitrogen is very very useful for the plant growth of the plants, growing of the plants, so building of the plant body. So but this nitrogen cannot take directly by plants. This rhizobium bacteria, converting the nitrogen into nitrates, then it can absorb. There are so many, like rhizobium bacteria, azotobacter, nastobacter, they are present in the legume plants. We'll discuss. discussed in next class. Legume plants, which one have brown nut. There is a small, we can see the legume plants like brown nut, like a pea plants. So this legume plants, in the legume node of this legume plant, the rhizobium bacteria is present. The plants giving shelter to this rhizobium bacteria. This rhizobium bacteria convert the nitrogen into nitrates. They're helping each other. Plants is giving shelter. Rhizobium bacteria converting nitrogen into nitrates. They're helping each other. This process is called as symbiosis. Come to the observing soil microorganism. Take one beaker. Yes, beaker or a jar and take a water in the beaker. Water in the beaker. Bring 2-3 spoon of soil from the bean, soil from the field. Mix the soil in the water. What happens? This water will be converted in turbines, like it's a pollution. You can see the dust particles in the water. Stir it well properly, mix it up, stir it well properly, this water contained with the soil. Let it keep few minutes like this only. So after few minutes, you can see the separation between this soil and the water. The transparent fluid will flow from the top portion of this beaker, like a decoction. Collect some drops of the water, collect some drop of the water. On the slide, collect some drop of the water on the slide. Then cover with the cover slip. Observe under the microscope. You can see the some picture of this observing microorganisms in the soil. On the soil. So this is about observing soil microorganism. Observing soil microorganisms. There are different dangerous and harmful microorganisms also is there. Useful microorganisms and harmful microorganism, they are very dangerous to us, our body. For example, they will cause us diseases in our body. There are so many microorganisms cause us diseases in our body. For example, HIV, human immunodeficiency. Deficiency syndrome, human immunodeficiency syndrome. AIDS causes this virus is called human immunodeficiency virus. Once upon days, a few years back, this AIDS was spreading very fastly. These are very, very dangerous. This is the entire world. Like a coronavirus. Everybody is afraid about this coronavirus. But in those days, those people are very, very afraid about this virus. Once it entered in our body, once the HIV virus entered in our body, it will not go away until it will take us. Okkasari manaloki vellina tarvata adi polu potu pota manalni kuda teeskoni vellipothundi. Anta varaku dani nidra podu. It will not sleep until it will take us. It will destroy the immunity power in our body. So this is a very, very dangerous. HIV virus. We will discuss in next class how much it is dangerous, how it will spread through the sexual transmission, through the blood donation from mother to baby. There are so many reasons about this causing of HIV. The main reason is sex transmission. The sexual transmission is HIV will be spread from one person to the another person. We should be careful about this HIV. Next one is tobacco mosaic virus. Tobacco mosaic virus. Tobacco mosaic virus. Polio. You know, polio, there is they can't work properly. Those are affected with this polio. So nowadays people are available. So we are using polio drops. It will be available freely. Smallpox, polio and smallpox. Conjunctivitis. Smallpox and conjunctivitis. Chickenpox. Common cold. Nowadays people are very afraid. If you are coughing, if you are sneezing, oh, coronavirus. We should be very careful. While we are sneezing, while we are coughing, we should compulsory, we should use mask. Otherwise it will spread very fastly from one person to the another person. These all diseases are spread by the viruses. Spread by viruses. Tobacco mosaic virus, HIV, polio, smallpox, conjunctivitis affected with the eyes, chickenpox, you know very about chickenpox and smallpox, common cold also affected with this viruses. Next one is typhoid. TB. Do you know about this TB? Tuberculosis. Typhoid fever, TB, tuberculosis, they will have mostly cough, TB or something. So, TB, tuberculosis. Septicemia, blood poisoning. Septicemia. These are the bacteria diseases. Bacteria, typhoid, tuberculosis, septicemia, like blood poisoning. There are some skin related diseases are fungi. We have itching. Skin related diseases are the fungi like scabies, mites are affected with the fungi. There are some other diseases also affected with the arthropods, protozoans. Protozoa is malaria and amoebiasis. Malaria. Amoebiasis. You can see the swollen leg from people, they have very big legs. Very big hands. The swollen legs, amoebiasis. Protozoa is a disease of the malaria. How malaria is caused? By the mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito. This malaria is caused by female Anopheles mosquitoes. So, protozoa, there comes under the protozoa. Arthropods, you can see arthropods, some animals sucking, some insects are sucking the animal juice. These are the different types of microorganisms. So the most is HIV. HIV, how the HIV is spread? Sexual transmission, blood donation from mother to baby. So while you are taking syringe also, the doctor should be use sterilized syringe only. So if the same syringe injected from AIDS person to the healthy person, the AIDS can transform from unhealthy to the healthy person. So the blood is donated from AIDS person to the healthy person, the AIDS virus can spread easily into the healthy persons. This is about HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. So there is no medicine for this virus. HIV virus, there is no medicine. Like COVID-19. So scientists are struggling for find out this vaccine for this COVID-19. But until there are so many years was gone, but they couldn't find out the medicine for the HIV. There is no medicine for the HIV. But there is a small medicine is there. They can increase the lifespan of the human being. But they cannot destroy the HIV virus. Once it enters in our body, it will affect on the WBC. So we will discuss about three types of blood vessels. One is RBC. Second one is WBC. Third one is platelets. So this HIV will fight against the immunity power. WBC, it will destroy the whole immunity power in our body. Once the HIV enter in our body, we cannot see the symptoms until 10 years. If they are outside the body, they look like non-living things. This virus are outside the body, they look like non-living things. Once they enter into the body, they will act like a living thing. These are the very, very dangerous viruses. If they are outside the host, outside the body, so they are looking like non-living things. But once they enter, it will start affecting. This HIV will fight against the WBC. They will destroy the WBC. Why? Because this WBC have the immunity power. If any harmful microorganisms enter in our body, this WBC will fight against the harmful microorganism and they will send outside the body. This HIV will directly fight on the WBC and they will destroy. If the immunity power is lost in our body, if any disease occurs, there is no cure for that. That's why it is very, very dangerous HIV. Tobacco, mosaic virus, polio, smallpox, casualties, chicken pox, common pox. How we can see the bacteria? Take a slide, spear some bacteria on the slide. Heat well is 3 seconds. And keep it for 30 to 60 seconds. And wash it properly, observe the microscope, electronic microscope. So we can see the bacteria in the slide. So we cannot see here, but we can see the labs, like pathology labs. We can see the microbiology labs. So this is about, the world of microorganisms. Part 1 is completed. Very, very simple lesson. So, I'm very, very short lesson to the entire world. So, today we discuss about observing of soil in microorganisms. And we discussed about the diseases occurs by the viruses, diseases occurs by bacteria, diseases occur by fungi, skin diseases, protozoa, malaria, and amoebiasis. Viruses, diseases. Okay? Today homework, write observing of soil microorganism. observing a soil microorganisms. So diseases affected by the viruses, these names. Diseases affected by the bacteria. Diseases affected by fungi, skin diseases like scabies, mites. Diseases occurred by protozoa. Diseases occurred by protozoa. Okay. Next class we will discuss part 2, the world of microorganism. Part 2, in deeply we will discuss about microorganisms. Okay.
Thank you, students.